हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द डिजिटल क्लासेस ऑफ क्राइस्टचर्च कॉन्वेंट गाडावारा। आई एम दीपक कौरव हियर विद द टॉपिक पार्ट्स ऑफ स्पीच इन विच आई एम टीचिंग यू अबाउट वर्ब। सो लेट्स लर्न समथिंग अबाउट वर्ब। वर्ब, लेट्स सी इट्स डेफिनेशन। अ वर्ब इज अ डूइंग वर्ड दैट शोज एन एक्शन, एन इवेंट और अ स्टेट। Okay, so it is a word that is used to indicate that something happens or exists called verb. Okay, let's see some examples: dance, sing, swim, etc. So these all are the examples of verb. Now, kinds of verb. So there are basically five kinds of verb: main verb or action verb, helping verb or auxiliary verb, linking verb, transitive verb and intransitive verb. Now, main verb or action verb. Definition: main verbs or action verbs are used to express action, something that an animal, a person or a thing does. Okay, main verb is also known as principal verb. Keep this in mind, main verb is also known as principal verb. They can be used with a helping verb. Okay, they can be used with a helping verb or auxiliary verb and may be used independently. Okay, so either it may be used with helping verb or auxiliary verb, or it may be used with independently. Okay, let's see some examples. They are going to market. Okay, so here going is a main verb and are is an auxiliary verb. Okay, so here main verb is used with an auxiliary verb. Okay, the monkey jumps. Okay, here jumps is a main verb and it is used independently. Okay, now helping verb or auxiliary verb. Let's see its definition. Helping verbs help or support the main verb. Okay, so it always support the main verb. Let's see some examples. We are learning about helping verbs. So here are is a helping verb which is supporting learning, which is main verb. Okay, you should complete the work by tomorrow. Here should is a helping verb which is also known as modal auxiliary verb. Okay, so which is supporting complete, which is a main verb. Okay, so here should, which is a helping verb, supporting complete, which is a main verb. Now, linking verbs. Definition: linking verbs explain a link between the subject of the sentence and a noun or adjective being linked to it. Okay, so linking verbs are mainly used to make a link in between subject and noun or adjective. Okay, so it is used mainly to make a link in between subject and noun or maybe adjective. Let's see some examples. The flowers are bright. Diamond is the hardest substance. So here are and is used to make a link of subject with an adjective or a noun. Now, transitive verb. Let's see its definition. This kind of verb shows an action which passes over from the subject to the object. Okay, so transitive verbs are directly connected with object and makes a complete sense. Let's see some examples. The teacher made the question paper. Peter cut the cake. Prem opens the door द काउ ईट ग्रास. सो हियर मेड, कट, opens, eat are the transitive verbs which are directly connected to the object. The question paper is a object, the cake is a object, the door is a object, grass is also a object. So made, cut, opens, eats, all are connected directly to the object, so that's why it's a transitive verb. They are transitive verb. Now, intransitive verb. Let's see its definition. This kind of verb shows an action which stops with its subject. It does not require object to complete its sense. So intransitive verbs does not require any object, okay, to complete its sense. Have you got it? Let's see some examples. Kamala sings. Okay, so Kamala sings, here this sentence does not need any object. Okay, the wicked hunter was hiding. So here also there is no need of any object. Okay, Mr. John speaks loudly. Okay, here also there is no need of any object, okay, to complete its sense. So this is all about verbs. Thank you.